Good morning, children. Hope you all are doing well and studying well at home and revising the topics done in the class. Children, up till now, we have completed our English treasure. And also, we have completed our first part of speech, that is noun. So children, in this video, I am going to start with the second part of speech, that is pronoun. So children, first of all, let's see what is a pronoun. Pronoun is a word used instead of a noun. So simply, if we talk about pronoun, pronoun are the words that are used in place of noun. Secondly, children, pronouns are substitutes to avoid repetition of noun. Children, see the example. Hari is absent because Hari is ill. Now, as I have told you, pronouns are used in the sentences or in the stories or anywhere to avoid the repetition of noun. So, this sentence can be like this. Hari is absent because he is ill. So, instead of using the noun Hari again and again, we have substituted it with the pronoun he, because Hari is a boy. So for boy, we have used the pronoun he. Now children, see the types of pronouns. We have 9 types of pronouns. The first one is personal pronoun, second reflexive pronoun, third emphatic pronoun, fourth indefinite, fifth relative, sixth demonstrative, seventh interrogative, eighth distributive, and the last one is possessive. So children, now we will discuss them one by one. So we will start with the personal pronoun. So children, coming to the definition, personal pronouns, it is clear from the name, it is used for the persons. So, I, we, you, he, she, it, they. These are called the personal pronouns. Because all stand for 3 persons. Children, we have first person, the person who is speaking. The second person, the person with whom we are talking. And the third person, about the person we are talking. So the first person is the speaker, second is the listener, and the third person about whom we are talking. Now children, see examples of personal pronouns. So first person is I and we. The singular is I and the plural is we. So children, can you see this? I, me, my, and mine. These are the cases of pronouns. In detail, I will teach you in the next video. Second, if we talk about plural we, so its cases are ours, our, and us. Second person is you. It's used as singular also and plural also. So its cases are you, your, and yours. Coming to the third person, singular. He, his, him, she, her, it, and its. And the plural is they, their, them. So children, we can see the sentences with personal pronouns like, this is my book. In this sentence, my is a personal pronoun because it is denoting a person. The next one is, you are wrong. Again, you is the second person personal pronoun. And in the last sentence, she is eating meal. So in the last sentence, it is the third person personal pronoun, she. Now, second is reflexive pronoun. So what it represents? It represents the action performed by the subject, is on the subject itself. So children, by this pronoun, we come to know that reflexive pronouns are the pronouns in which action comes on to the subject itself. Whatever is done by the subject, that is done to the subject only. That comes back to the, that reflexes to the subject again. So children, for making reflexive pronouns, we used to add two words. First is self and second is selves. So being singular, self is added to my, your, him and her. And selves is added to the plural pronouns, that is our, them, your. Now children, we'll see some examples of reflexive pronoun. The first one is, I hurt myself. So children, in this sentence, myself is the reflexive pronoun because whatever is done by the subject I is hurting himself. I hurt myself. So the action reflexes upon to the subject itself. See the second example, they hurt themselves. So, they have hurt themselves only, not anyone else. Children, now coming to the third pronoun, that is emphatic pronoun. So, an emphatic pronoun is that which is used to add emphasis to the subject of the sentence. Means, we emphasize the subject, we emphasize the action done by the subject. Again, self and selves are added to make emphatic pronouns. Now children, first of all, we will see the sentences. See the first one, I will do it myself. In this sentence, myself is an emphatic pronoun. Because in this pronoun, emphasis is given to the subject that whatever has to be done will be done by the subject itself. See the second one, we will see to it ourselves. That whatever the matter is, we will see it ourselves, not anyone else. In these sentences, the subject is the primary one. She herself says so. Means she herself has said this thing, no one else. Now children, to make them more clear, we have to look the difference between the reflexive pronoun and emphatic pronoun. Because both are made by adding self and selves. Still, we will see how they are different from each other. Now children, see, reflexive pronoun, they are used as objects of the verb when the action of the verb returns to the doer. Children, already I have told you whatever the subject is doing in the reflexive pronoun, that reflexes, that comes back to the subject only. The subject and the object of the sentence are the same person, like I hurt myself. That the subject I has hurt whom? He has hurt himself only. So the subject is I and the object is also myself. So I hurt myself. So both the subject and the object are same and the action done by the subject comes back to the subject. There is no other person. Whereas in the emphatic pronoun, they are used to emphasize noun or pronoun. Like she herself opened the door. Here, whatever is done by the subject, we use to emphasize noun or pronoun. That the door is not opened by anyone else, she herself did it. So, we are emphasizing the pronoun here.